Hello everyone, and welcome to the One Stop Co-op Shop. Today my wife and I are going to do a two-player playthrough of Orléans Invasion, the co-op version.
Yes!
I'm excited. My favorite way to play Orléans, it is fantastic. If you want to see how to set up the game, check out the video before this. Otherwise, keep watching and watch us go through the playthrough. Still here? Awesome! Alright, so first thing we got to do is flip an event tile, so let's do that. Our first event is Trip. Unfortunately, this is not good. It is if any of us has one of our merchants in Orléans at the end of this round, we lose 4 coins. So let's see what we're going to do. For the first round, I'm first player, and the only thing I'm going to do is activate the castle. This will allow me to move up the knight track and to obtain a knight. Monica is also going to activate the knight's track. So now we've ended round one, and unfortunately, since neither of us moved out of Orléans because we didn't have knights, we both lose 4 coins. Ouch. This means we both only get 1 coin left. Alright, let's go to round two. So now, first thing we do is we move the first player token over to Monica. So Monica's now first player. And we get a nice donation. We get 3 determination, or not determination, 3 development, 1 wine, and looks like 3 coins, I think? Yeah, 3 coins. Pretty nice. Monica's being awesome and letting me take the 3 development points, which means I get my first citizen tile. That already is 1 out of the 2 that I need to complete my personal objective. Monica then is going to take the wine and the coins. Monica, for this round, is going to activate the village. Monica's going to grab a craftsman and get a technology token and move up the craftsman track. Colin is going to activate the village as well. And I'm going to go grab a boatman, move up the boatman track, and get 2 coins. I also have the craft guild activated, and I'm going to give my 3 coins up to the castle itself. We now have 3 out of 30 coins. Only 27 left, Monica. At the end of the round, Monica gets to place her technology tile, and she's placing it in the castle. That way she can get her knights a little bit easier. And as you saw, she covered up the farmer. You have to, that first time, cover up the farmer, any farmer worker spot, before you can fill up anything else. Now, when she gets a technology token, she can put it anywhere on her board, as long as she's not putting 2 on the same action. Let's start the next round. So now I'm going to be first player, and at the end of this round, we're going to have a drought, and we have to give up 4 grain tokens on the board. Ouch. All right, I had a terrible draw, so I'm actually not even using 3 of my workers. I'm just going to the farm to get a farmer. That means I can grab a farmer, move up the track, and get a piece of grain. Monica also is only activating 3, or activating 1 using 3 of her people. She's going to the village. Monica's going to grab another craftsman and get another technology token. This means she's already halfway done with that part of her objective. Nice, Mon. There we go. Now we lose 4 grain tiles. What do you think, Mon? Which one should we lose? I'm thinking the middle ones. No, because we usually go around on the outside, don't we? To do the... I don't know. We definitely don't want to get rid of this one. No. That one up there? How about this one? Because most likely you're going to come down and you prefer to get the brocade anyways. Probably. And then let's just... this one. Because why would we go there? There's already a trading post. Alright, that's end of round 3, I think. Monica's placed her technology token on the university. She's going to be looking like she's going for some scholars. All right, the beginning of round 4. So we can, at the end of this round, pay 8 coins to put 3 pieces of grain directly into the warehouse. That sounds awesome. Let's see if we can do it. All right, so this round, Monica is going to activate the village. She's going to get a boatman to get some moolah. All right, so she's going to move up the track. She's going to get 2 coins and a boatman. Oops. I've been lucky enough since I didn't use three of my people. I'm going to activate the castle and the village. So let's do the castle first. This is going to allow me to draw another knight and move up the knight track. Now I can get six around.
Yes.
All right, next let's activate the village. Here's the boatman. I'm going to get three coins because I'm moving up the track even farther. And look at that. Monica and I had eight coins. She had one left over, so we were just there. But that means we can put three grain into the warehouse directly. So here's the warehouse, and Monica's going to place the three. Heck yeah, halfway there for the grain. We only need three more. Another good event for round five. Good wins. At the end of this round, one of us, either Monica or I, can use the waterway for free. For this round, I'm only going to activate the village. I'm going to go up the trader track and get a trader. This will allow me to get a goods tile. I got the herb garden, which is going to make all my boatmen wild for any of the four basic ones. The farmer, the trader, or the craftsman. Monica gets to activate three this round. The castle, the farmhouse, and the university. Which one do you want to do first? Farmer. Okay, we're going to grab the farmer first. Alright, she's going to grab a farmer and move up the track to get a piece of grain. Nice. Next, she's going to activate the castle since I'm all done. This is going to allow her to move up the track, and now she's going to be able to draw six around. Last, she's going to do the university. This is going to allow her to get a scholar and move up the scholar track and go two up the development track. At the end of the round, we get to use our good wins, and Monica's going to move out through one of the waterways. And she's picking up some brocade. Another nice event for round six, I think we're at. Support. We get to, at the end of this round, just draw a worker from our bag, and we get another one and move up the track. Not bad. For this round, Monica's just going to activate the village. Monica's going to go for a tradesman. This means she can get a level one place tile. Monica grabbed the library, which is pretty cool, because she can use a knight and a scholar and move two up the development track. Nice. I'm activating the castle and the village. So let's do the castle first. I'll grab a knight and move up the knight track. This means I'm going to get to draw seven. Next, I'm going to activate the village. I'm going to follow in Monica's footsteps, get a craftsman and a technology tile. I'm going to place mine here on the ship, so next round, I can activate the ship without having to place any more people there. All right, so here's our support action. Let's see what we get. Yeah. Nice! Monica gets a trader, and I get a boatman, so let's go do that. All right, so Monica and I are both going to grab. Monica's going to get another goods tile, which is great, and I'm going to get four coins. And for me, that's a wild, which is pretty nice. Monica got the school, which is great because now all of her scholars are going to be wild for anything except for monks. And I can't believe it. We still haven't gotten a single monk, Monica. We've got to work on that. We are having some good luck here. This round we have training. So at the end of this round we can advance on any track. We don't get the follower, but we're still going to get the benefit. Pretty cool. For this round, I'm going to activate the ship and the village. So let's do the village first. Looks like I'm getting another boatman for me. Yes. That gives me five coins. Monica's going to activate the ship, the castle, and the university. Looks like she's going to do the castle first. This means she's going to be able to draw seven from her bag, and she's one away from that citizen tile. Next, I'm going to do the ship action. I'm going to move down and grab that piece of grain. And I'm not even going to try and pronounce the places, because I was terrible at that before. Sorry. Monica's going to activate the ship. Looks like she's going to grab some wine. Oh, and her merchant fell over. Looks like I'm going to go to the farmhouse next. All right, you guys, I was just about to grab that farmer, but my wife caught me cheating. I apparently used a knight as a craftsman, which apparently doesn't work. So I'm going to place that knight somewhere else, and I'm not getting a farmer. Last but not least, Monica, who's not cheating, is going to activate the university. Monica's going to move up the track And then she also gets to move 3 up the development track as well. She's now at development level 2, which is great. At the end of the round, we each get to choose a track to move up on. We get the benefit of it, but no follower. So Monica and I are going to grab 2 citizen tiles here. I'm going to move up the boatman track, and she's going to move up the knight track. And this means I have my first or my second citizen tile, and we have our first for the castle. We only need 6 more. That's actually sounds a lot more doable. Our next action, progress. We can, at the end of this round, pay 4 coins to build a fortified tower in our location. So let's see if Monica or I can get into the right spot and build one for 4 bucks. Monica is being uber productive this round. She's going to do the farmhouse, the village, the university, and the monastery. So why don't you do the monastery first, since we haven't done that this game. She's going to grab a monk. Now here's the thing, there's no track. So she's not going to move up any track, but the monk is wild for anything, including, well, monks themselves. So she's got tons of wilds now, because any of her scholars are wild and her monks are wild. Colin's lagging a little behind Monica. Well, actually, maybe not. I'm activating 4, too. I'm doing the ship, the castle, the farmhouse, and the village. So let's do the castle first. I'm going to grab another knight. Move up the track. Now, the only reason I really did this is just so I can get some knights to throw them up on the wall. Next, Monica's doing the village. Guess what she's getting? A craftsman getting another technology tile so that she can get, what is that, your third one? Is that your third one on the board? Is that right? Yeah, so that means she only has 1 more that she needs to get. I can't have Monica have all the fun in the village. I'm going to do the village now. I am also going to grab a craftsman. Thank goodness there's only 2 left. And that's going to give me a technology token. Monica now is going to activate the farmhouse. Oh, thank you, Monica. And she has a scholar there, and it's being wild, so it's being used as a boatman. And so you see, she's not cheating, unlike me. She's going to grab a farmer, and she gets another grain. We got lots of grain. Apparently, I like to follow in her footsteps, because I'm going to activate the farmhouse too. But since Monica's ahead of me, unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to get cheese. I'm only going to get grain. Last but certainly not least, Monica's going to activate the university. She's going to move up, get 4 development points, and get another scholar. And she passes 3, so she gets 3 coins, and she's at the 3 development. She is cruising. My final action is the ship. This is where I get a piece of cheese. At the end of this round, I'm going to pay 4 coins. And I can build a fortified tower in my current location. This will be 1 of the 7 that we have to do, so I think we only have to do 6 more. And Monica apparently just knocked my merchant over. Alright, that's the end of the round. I've placed my technology token on the monastery, and Monica placed her 3rd technology token on the wagon. For this round, we cannot use the town hall. That should be okay, we're totally still working on our engines here. For this round, I am finally going to be able to get a monk. I'm going to go actually do the transport, the craft guild, the monastery, the farmhouse, and ship. Whew, that's a lot. Let's do the farmhouse first. Now I am finally going to be better than Monica on the farm track and get a piece of cheese. Monica's going to activate the castle, the wagon, the monastery, and the university. Let's do the university first. And she has a monk that she's using, a total wild one. So Monica's going to go up the track, she grabs another scholar, and she gets 5 development points, which is going to get her another 4 coins, and she's 1 step away from 4. I hope we get that income card event, which allows you to get coins worth of the development that she's at. She'll get tons of money. Next, I'm going to activate the ship. This is going to allow me to grab another piece of grain, and I'm in another spot where I can build another fortified tower. Monica's going to activate the wagon. Monica's going to do a nice long road over there, and she's going to grab that piece of brocade, and she's ready to add another fortified tower. I think we're doing pretty well so far. Don't get too excited, but I'm finally going to get a priest or a monk. So here I am grabbing a monk. Monica's going to finish one part of her card and go to the castle. She's going to grab the final knight, and she is now at the... She gets to draw 8 around. Wow, fills up her entire market. Lucky her. I'm going to activate the transport goods. And I'm going to transport these 3 goods to the warehouse. That is going to finish this section of the goods that we need for the warehouse just for the grains. We still need cheese and wine. Monica is also going to activate the monastery. She's going to grab a monk as well. Not as cool of a monk as mine, obviously. Last, I'm going to activate the craft guild. And I'm going to give up 4 coins to the treasury. Monica's going to place those 4 into the treasury. We now, I think, have 4 plus 3, right? 7? So we are almost to our first set of 10. Remember, we need 30 total. Plus, I need 10 myself. We have now moved to the B events. That means we have 9 rounds left, you guys. We have a lot to do. And we now have a witch hunt. So at the end of this round, somebody, or between our team, we're going to have to lose 6 development points. Ouch. For this round, Monica is going to activate the wagon, the guild house, and the monastery. So let's do the guild house first. Monica's going to set another fortified tower out. I think we only have, 5 left? 6, 5. Yeah, it's pretty good. I'm going to activate the guild hall, the monastery, and the farmhouse. I'm going to do the guild hall first. I'm going to place my trading post, or I should call it a fortified tower here. And actually, we just counted. We only have 3 left, you guys. It's awesome. Monica's going to activate her wagon next. Looks like she's going to go and pick up some wool. And she is ready to put up another fortified tower. Next, I'm going to go and get another monk. There's not many left of those, so we're going to grab them as quick as we can. Like I said, Monica is also going to grab a monk. After Monica takes this monk, we only have 3 left. I think we're going to grab them all. Lastly, I'm going to activate the farmhouse. We're going to be able to move up this track and get another piece of cheese. At the end of this round, we're going to have to lose a total of 6 development points. We're going to split this up 3 and 3. This means Monica can potentially get 4 more coins again because she moved past that on the track. So, although it's bad, it also is slightly good. I am liking this event. It is called Fishing Grounds. We get money equal to our level on the boatman track. That means I'm going to get 5 coins and Monica's going to get 1. I'm going to activate the transport, the monastery, the town hall, and the village. So let's do the new one first, the town hall. I'm going to put up one of the first knights, or the first knight, on the wall. We need to do that with 5 of them. That's our first one, so 4 more to go. Monica's going to activate the guild hall, the village, and the transport. So she's going to do the guild hall first. She's going to build our 3rd to last trading post / fortified tower. So we only have 2 more that we have to do. Next, I'm going to transport some goods. I'm going to place my 3 cheese into the warehouse. Now all we need is 3 wine to complete this objective. Monica is going to go to the village. And what are you going to get? Monica is going to get her final craftsman and her final technology tile that she needs. I'm going to use a monk to gain a monk. We're only going to have 2 left. Monica's final action is going to be to transport. She's going to do 2 pieces of wine. And 1 of the 3 brocade that we need to maybe get that citizen tile. We'll need 3 brocade and 3 wool. My final action is going to be going to the village. I'm going to grab another trader and get 1 more goods tile, or place tile. The well is a very special tile. You have to place a monk and a boatman on there, but then you can activate any action on your board, even one that you have filled out with other workers. So I could do ship action twice if I wanted. Pretty cool, but I have to use a monk. Monica's being a genius here, and she's placing her technology item, or technology token, on the library. And that also completes her personal objective. She now has done the night track, and she has 4 technology tokens. Oh, it's awesome. At the end of this round, we get to get some coins because of the fishing grounds. I'm going to get 5, and Monica's going to get 1. Looks like we're going to have a harvest for this round. So at the end of this round, Monica and I each are going to have to give up a grain, a wine, or a cheese, or 5 coins. Monica's having a great round this time. She's going to activate the library, the wagon, the town hall, the craft guild, and the village. So let's do the library first. With the library action, she's going to be able to move 2 up the development track. This also is going to allow her to get 4 coins. Monica has a total of 13 coins. Man, she's rich. I'm going to activate the wagon, the town hall, and the monastery. I think that's it. So let's do the town hall first. I'm going to be able to place a knight on the wall, which is great, and then a farmer over here. And hopefully we can get a total of 5 and get that citizen tile, because we only have 1 up there. We need another 6. Monica's also going to activate the town hall. She's going to place 1 up on the wall as well, so we now only need 2 more knights up there. I'm going to activate the wagon. This is going to allow me to move and get some wine, as well as start getting me over to the 2 last spots that we need to put up some fortified towers. Monica's also going to activate the wagon. Monica's returning back to Orléans and is going to get a piece of wool. Nice. And she has a hard time picking up her goods and knocking over her merchant tile and forgetting which good that she's supposed to pick up. It's pretty funny. Looks like I'm using a monk to get a monk. Now there's going to only be 1 monk left. Hopefully I can get it. Monica's now going to go to the village. She's going to grab a tradesman, and that's going to allow her to get a level 2 place tile. Monica is all about the money. She's going to get the seller, which allows her to use a monk and a scholar, and she can get 4 coins. Nice. Looks like those monks are making some good brew. Last, Monica is going to activate the craft guild, as I don't have any other actions to do. Monica's going to put up 4 coins up to the treasury there. That's going to put us up to 11 coins, so we're over a third way done. Unfortunately, a little bit more to go. Now we have our harvest. Each of us are going to give up a grain. And that will end this round. For this round, each of us are going to get income received based on what our level is on the development track. Monica's at 3, I'm at 1. I'm only going to get 1 coin. It is what it is. We're hoping Monica can get to 4. Let's see if we can do it. For this run, I'm going to activate the well, the wagon, and the farmhouse. So let's do the wagon first. I'm going to move and be able to pick up that wine. Nice. Monica's going to activate the wagon, the monastery, the town hall, and the university. Let's do the town hall first. She's going to place her trader at the Council of Orléans. Maybe we're not going to get that one done, but if we do, hey, another citizen tile. We're going to need it. Next, I'm going to activate the farmhouse. I'm going to grab a farmer and get a piece of wine. Monica's going to activate the wagon. Monica's going to move to Verzon, and if you guys have seen any of my solo plays, you know that the capital of Verzon is one of those specific scenarios. Loved it. It's the only one I lost. Still fun. My final action is going to be the well, and I'm going to use the wagon action for my one of any actions that I have on my board. Now I can move and pick up some brocade. And I'm in a perfect spot for another fortified tower. Monica is apparently cooler than me because she's going to get the last monk. She's going to grab him, and that is it. No more monks for us. Monica's final action is going to be to go to the university. Monica's going to move up to the final spot on this track, get a scholar, and move up 6 points. And that means we have our second citizen tile out of 7. So we have five more to go. We are going to end with our event, and that is our income event. Monica's going to get 4 coins, and I'm going to get 1. We have a pretty bad event here, summoning. At the end of this round, we have to either go back to Orléans or we pay 5 coins. I don't want to go back to Orléans, so I might have to pay 5 coins, which is not good because I need to end with 10 coins, and I only have 7 right now. We'll see what we can do. Let's go. Monica is doing a ton of actions here. The cellar, the library, transport, craft guild, hostel. So let's do the hostel first. This is a new action. So what she's going to do is she's going to give up her monk and then give me the knight, and I can immediately place it on my board. I'm going to place that knight on the wagon action. And that's what I'm going to do. No, I'm not going to do that first. I'm going to do the guild hall first. And what I'm going to activate is the guild hall, the wagon, and the well. That's the 3 that I'm doing. So I'll do the guild hall first. I'm going to place my fortified tower here. That means we only need 1 more fortified tower, and we've got the full outside of Orléans completely safe. Nice. Monica's going to do the transport next. Monica's going to throw 3 wool. And that means we just need 2 brocade, and we've got that citizen tile. Thanks to Monica, I'm going to activate my wagon action. Now, as you see, I took her knight, and it now goes back into my bag. She no longer has the knight. I'm going to move and pick up some wool. Next, Monica's going to activate the craft guild. Monica's bringing 4 coins up to the treasury, and that gets us to 5. We're at 15, halfway there. I'm going to activate my well, and with that, I'm going to do another guild hall action. We are going to place our final fortified tower. Yes, we've completed objective 5. Monica's going to activate both the cellar and the library. The cellar's going to give her 4 coins, and the library's going to let her move up 2 on the development track. She's going to move up 2 on that development track. That's going to put her 1 away from 5, and she's getting close to that citizen tile. And 5 more coins. We're at the end of the round here, and we are both going to go and be summoned back to Orléans. It means we're going to miss the citizen tile on the Blanc, but maybe I can get it later. For this round, we only have 4 left. We have rats. We're going to lose 1 grain and 2 cheese at the end of this round. For this round, I'm going to activate the well, the wagon, the town hall, and the farmhouse. So let's do the wagon first. I'm going to move my merchant back to Verzon. Thank you, Monica. Monica's going to activate the library, the wagon, the town hall, the craft guild, and I think that's it. So let's do the library first. She's now going to move up past the number 5, and she's 2 away from 5 more coins. She is so rich! Next, I'm going to activate the well. And I'm going to use that as another wagon action. With this wagon action, I'm going to pick up some grain. And I am 1 away from that citizen's tile. Yes. Monica's going to do the wagon action. With two monks, as she tells me. And she's going to get some cheese. Because those blasted rats are going to take some away. Next, I'm going to do the town hall. We're going to put another farmer up on the civil defense. And that's going to mean we only need 3 more to get that citizen tile. Monica's going to activate the craft guild. She's going to place 4 more coins. That makes this up to 19. My final action is the farmhouse. Let's go get a farmer. I'm going to grab a farmer and get another piece of wine. Only 2 more farmers and I can get another citizen tile. Now the rats happen, and so we're going to lose 1 grain and 2 cheese. Such a bummer. We had essentially a completed warehouse. Now it's not so much. For this round, we're going to have pirates come, and we're going to have to lose any wool or brocade that's on waterways. That's not too bad for us. Monica is going to activate the library, the wagon, the town hall, the craft guild, and the transport. Whew! So let's do the library first. Guess who's going to get 5 coins? For this round, I'm just going to activate the farmhouse, the village, and the town hall. Let's do the town hall first. We're going to place up our 4th out of 5 knights. Only 1 more we need. Monica also is going to activate the town hall. She's going to put up her craftsman and a farm person at the Council of Orléans and Civil Defense. We know that the Council of Orléans we're not going to finish. She's just trying to get it out of her bag. It pains me to use two monks for this, but I am going to go to the village. I'm going to grab a trader. I'm picking up the market stand, and here I can buy or sell goods two times in one round. Guess what I'm going to be doing? Somehow Monica's going to use two monks and a technology token to wagon. Looks like she's going to move to get some more cheese. We got to make up for those rats. My last action's going to be the farmhouse. I'm going to grab another farmer and a piece of wool. And what is awesome is I am one away from a citizen tile. Whew. Monica's going to activate both the transport and the craft guild. She's going to be able to place up two cheese and a brocade, which I'm not on screen, but that's okay. She put a brocade up. And she's going to do four coins. One more is going to make 10, and we've got three left. So what, we need seven more? That feels really good. And if you look over here, all she needs is one more brocade. And then we've got that citizen tile as well. Wow, we are really getting close, you guys. We can taste it. Sorry about the muffling there, you guys. I was not by the mic. I apologize. Now we're at the pirate here. And here's the thing. We don't have any brocade or wool that's on a waterway, so it has no effect. So it's going to end our round. We have two rounds left. For our second to last round, we have Bon Voyage. This means we can pay two coins at the end of the round to be able to move our merchant. That is awesome. For this round, I'm going to activate the market stand, the farmhouse, and the town hall. And Monica's going to help me with my transport. So I'm going to start with the market stand. I'm going to give up two pieces of wool for 8 coins. And that is going to allow me to complete my objective because I already have 7. 7 plus 8 is 15. 15 coins is enough to complete my personal objective. Yes! Monica's going to do the library, the town hall, the craft guild, and the hostel. She's going to activate the hostel first and give me a craftsman. I get to place that craftsman in the transport area. Let's activate that now. I'm giving these three goods, wine, brocade, and grain. So Monica's going to put those out for me, and that's going to complete one citizen tile, plus our warehouse is going to be complete as well, which is awesome. So that is our third citizen tile. We only need 4 more. Now, we didn't tell you this because Monica did this when we were looking at deciding where to put our workers. She decided to pull back one of her boatmen that was sitting out on the ship, and she then drew one less from her bag, but that means that now she can put a boatman up through the town hall action, which is what she's going to do, as well as the knight. Putting the boatman and the knight up, the knight is going to allow us to finish our first objective, which is awesome. So we've got objective 1, objective 4, and objective 5 complete, and the boatman means we only need 3 more people up there to complete the Council of Orléans. Since we're in the town hall mood, I'm going to activate my town hall. I'm going to place up my last two needed farmers to complete another, what is that, the city's defense?
Civil defense.
And that means we have 4 citizen tiles. We need 3 more. We're doing it, guys. Next is the craft guild. Monica's going to get up 4 coins up to the treasury. With doing this, Monica's going to put up a total of what? What are we at now? 8?
7.
Okay, we're at 7. So we just need 3 more coins and we complete objective 3. My last action is going to be the farmhouse. I'm going to get my last farmer and another citizen tile. Only 2 left that we need. Monica is now going to activate the library. She's going to move up 2 more on the track, and now she's only 1 away from yet another citizen tile. Last but not least, we have Bon Voyage. I'm going to pay 2 coins so I can move my merchant. Here's 5, and I'm going to get 3 back. I still have more than 10, so I should be good. This means we're going to be able to get the citizen tile on the block. We now only need 1 more citizen tile. The 18th and final round, Invasion. So we have to have everything completed by the end of this round to win the game, or we will be invaded and taken over. Let's see if we can do it. You guys, it looks like we did it. So we're just going to finish this off, show you guys how to win, and we're going to go to bed happy. So Monica, this round is going to activate the Town Hall, the Craft Guild, and the Library. So let's do the Library first. The Library is perfect. She can grab our final citizen tile that we need. And she's actually one away from being all the way at development level 6. Awesome. All I'm really going to do is activate the Town Hall, because that's all I really need to do. This allows us to put one up on the farmer area for the Council of Orléans. Monica's going to activate the Town Hall and the Craft Guild now, and we're going to finish the game. Monica's first going to go to the Council of Orléans and finish that, and we're going to get one extra tile, citizen tile, because we are just that good or lucky. And then she's going to give up 4 coins. She only is going to have, 2 coins left? She had to use quite a few coins here, but that's going to get us 30 coins in the treasury. And that means we are going to win the game. Woohoo! So Monica and I really enjoy this one. It's a lot of fun. It is a lot of planning. And at the beginning, you just feel like, how are you ever going to be able to do it? But we did. And that is, I think, only our third time that we've won. And that's the first time we've won with a hard character. So, and as you saw, Monica helped me out a ton. She kept giving me stuff. So 2 of us at hard, we're still going to have a challenge on. So there's tons of replayability on this. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And thanks for watching.